Hello and welcome to Timeless Life Skills. In this video series, we will explain how you can start a digital media literacy club at your school. These videos are meant for schools Timeless Life Skills works with, but we hope that these videos will also prove useful to teachers and students in other schools. The first project we will do in the digital media literacy club, which is learning to design a website, will be useful for anyone who wants to learn how they can design a simple and elegant website using free tools like WordPress or Mobirise. But why start a digital media literacy club in your school? Well, simply because the kind of skills and competencies needed to shine in the 21st century are not covered that well, if at all, in the prescribed syllabus. Thus, if we want our students to do well later in life, as teachers or parents, we should make sure that they learn the right skills. And communicating using digital media is a very important skill to learn in the hyper-connected world we now live in. Most students today, either in school or at home, have access to digital devices like smartphones, tablets, laptops, and PCs. And the projects we will do in this club will help students learn how to effectively use these devices for purposes of communication, self-expression, and even for advocacy about causes that they care about. The projects students will do in this club will also build essential skills of inquiry and information authentication, much needed in a world where dubious and fake news is on the rise. Digital media skills are also vocational skills 2.0 that facilitate later employability in media jobs like animation, graphic design, photography, filmmaking, virtual reality, and more. The projects will also cultivate critical life skills like creative thinking, planning, decision-making, time and resource management, collaboration, comfort with technology, and so forth. The first project we will do is learn how to design a website for your school. Later, students can use what they learn to create their own websites, be it a blog about a topic that they are interested in, or a portfolio website if the student is an artist or a musician, or a website just about themselves. Teachers can also create their own websites later. Much needed to build your brand if you want to become a rock star teacher. In one school where we did this project, one parent later asked if the students could create a website for his small family business. A big morale booster for the club members and a possible future entrepreneurial opportunity. We will kick off the website design project by discussing what purpose or objective our school website wishes to achieve. Based on this, we will define a target audience for our website and do a needs analysis. What are the information needs of various segments of our target audience? We will then create a site map or what is called the information architecture of our website. Next step will be to create a storyboard for our website for which we will use PowerPoint so that students also learn how to use this tool. Here, we will write the text or what is called the copy of our website and find or create right visual elements like photos and videos that will be used in each section. We will then look at defining the style guide for our website, which is imperative if we want our users to have a great experience when they visit our website. Components of the style guide include the color palette, and for this, we will look at the color wheel. We will then look at various fonts and figure out what font combinations we will use on our website. Next, we will define the layout and navigation of our website, which are critical for improving the user experience. While discussing the layout, we will keep in mind that our users may view the website on a PC, tablet, or a smartphone. And we want our website to display elegantly no matter what device is being used for viewing. Ensuring that a website displays elegantly across devices is called responsive design. We will also learn about internet award websites that are a rich source to get ideas and inspirations for designing our own website. Once all this has been established, that is when we will actually get down to making our website using free tools like Mobirise or WordPress. But before we jump into execution, we will develop our understanding of how the internet works. For this, we will take a brief overview of what is client-server technology, what is a domain name or URL, what is an IP address, what is the web host, and so forth. We will also briefly discuss search engine optimization, or SEO, that is needed if you want your website to rank higher in search engine results. We will then create our website, test it on different devices, and go live, which means make our website available to the public at large. Finally, we will briefly look at how we can publicize our website. So, let's get started. we will look at defining the purpose of our website and our target audience, and then do a needs analysis so that we can create a sitemap. More on this in the next video.